welcome to Byte Size Med. This video is a compilation of a bunch of recall cards that I've created on connective tissue. I've put together 8 quizzes and each is about a minute long. If you'd like to do them at random, you can check out my playlist linked in the description box below. So press pause when I tell you to and try to recall as much as you can. Let's start with a special cell, the fibroblast. Your task is to recall which tissue the cell is located in. What is its function? Is it an active cell or an inactive cell? Fibroblasts are found in skin, but which layer of skin has them? You can pause the video here and take as much time as you need to recall what you know about these cells. But I just get 1 minute, so time's up. Fibroblasts are the main cells of connective tissue. Its job is to synthesize proteins for the extracellular matrix, making it important for things like wound healing. It's an active cell versus the fibrocyte, which is a more mature and a less active cell. The dermis of skin is the connective tissue layer of skin, and it's got fibroblasts. These are called dermal fibroblasts. That's a cell. This tissue also has fibers. Connective tissue has protein fibers. Your task is to recall which cell synthesizes proteins for these fibers. What are the 3 main types of fibers? Which is archaerophilic? Which has desmosin crosslinks, and which is the most abundant. You can pause the video here and take as much time as you need. But I just get 1 minute, so time's up. There are 3 main protein fibers in connective tissue: collagen, reticulin, and elastin. The proteins for these fibers are synthesized by fibroblasts. Collagen is the most abundant, also making it the most abundant protein in the body. Reticular fibers are archaerophilic, meaning they stain black with silver stains. And elastin is the one with desmosin crosslinks. There are different types of connective tissue. Your task is simple. Match an example with the type of this tissue that it has. The lamina propria of the gastrointestinal tract, cartilage, tendons, and the dermis. Are they dense, regular, dense, irregular, loose, or specialized connective tissue? You can pause the video here and take as much time as you need. But I just get 1 minute, so time's up. The lamina propria is loose connective tissue. The dermis of skin is dense connective tissue. It's dense, irregular. Tendons are dense, regular connective tissue, and cartilage is a specialized form of connective tissue. The most abundant protein in connective tissue is collagen. Your task is to recall which cell synthesizes collagen. Collagen has a repeating amino acid sequence. Which amino acid is consistently present in that sequence? Collagen synthesis has a few key enzymes. One is involved in hydroxylation. Which vitamin is needed for that step? Collagen gets cross-linked by an enzyme dependent on which mineral. You can pause the video here and take as much time as you need to recall what you know about collagen synthesis. But I just get 1 minute, so time's up. Collagen is synthesized by fibroblasts. It's a triple helix with a glycine XY repeating sequence. Glycine repeats in each set. The hydroxylation of proline to hydroxyproline by prolyl hydroxylase needs vitamin C. And the cross-linking enzyme, lysyl oxidase, is copper dependent. There are lots of different types of collagen distributed throughout the body. We'll be matching the different types of collagen with the areas where they're found. There are over 28 different types of collagen, but these 4 are the most important, type 1, 2, 3, and 4. That's our column on the left. On the right, let's put down some examples. The basement membrane, tendons, the vitreous humor of the eye, and the spleen. Now you have to match the type of collagen with its location. You can press pause on this video here and take as much time as you need to sort them out. But I just get 1 minute, so time's up. Type 1 collagen is found in tendons. It's also found in bone and the dermis of skin. Type 2 collagen is in the vitreous humor of the eye. It's also found in cartilage. Type 3 collagen are actually reticular fibers. They're in the spleen, liver, and bone marrow. And type 4 collagen forms the floor of epithelial cells. That would be the basement membrane. 4 for floor. Next, we'll look at another special cell, the chondroblast. Your task for this is to recall which tissue has chondroblasts. Where in this tissue are these cells located? Which cell forms a chondroblast? And what does it do? You can pause the video here and take as much time as you need for recall. but I just get 1 minute, so time's up. The chondroblast is located in cartilage, which is connective tissue. The chondro in it tells you that. Chondro is cartilage. It's located in the perichondrium. The perichondrium has an outer fibrous layer and an inner cellular layer. The inner cellular layer has those chondroblasts. They are perichondrial cells, and they form from mesenchymal stem cells. They synthesize proteins for the extracellular matrix. That's the matrix that surrounds the cells. Chondroblasts are needed for cartilage repair, maintenance, and growth. Cartilage is a specialized form of connective tissue. Your task is to recall what type of collagen does cartilage predominantly have. What are the two important cells of cartilage? What are the three types of cartilage? And a lot of bones develop from a cartilaginous template. What is that process called? You can pause the video here and take as much time as you need to recall what you know about cartilage. But I just get 1 minute, so time's up. Cartilage predominantly has type 2 collagen, except for fibrocartilage, which mainly has type 1. This collagen is synthesized by chondroblasts. The other important cell is the chondrocyte. The three types of cartilage are hyaline, elastic, and fibrocartilage. Bones develop by a process called ossification, and when that happens from a cartilaginous template, it's called endochondral ossification. Cartilage is located in different parts of the body. The three types are distributed in the body depending on their function. Your last task is to match the type with the location. Hyaline, elastic, and fibrocartilage. Now we put down some examples. Annulus fibrosus, the thyroid cartilage. Medial meniscus, the auditory tube. The epiphyseal growth plate, and the epiglottis. You can pause the video here and take as much time as you need. Your task is to match the examples with the type of cartilage. But I just get 1 minute, so time's up. The annulus fibrosus is part of the intervertebral disc. It's layers of fibrocartilage. The thyroid cartilage is a laryngeal cartilage. It is hyaline cartilage. The medial meniscus is a shock absorber in the knee joint. It's fibrocartilage. The auditory tube or the eustachian tube is elastic cartilage. The epiphyseal growth plate undergoes ossification for bones to reach their final length, hyaline cartilage. Lastly, the epiglottis, the easiest one, E for E, elastic cartilage. That's all I've got for now. A quick tip for studying histology is to focus on the functional aspects of it. The tissue is structured the way it is for a reason. The cells, the matrix, they've all got a job to do. So try not to memorize the things you see in histology. Instead, question why this particular tissue has this structure. I hope these recall cards were helpful. Leave me a comment if you do like them and if you'd want more on other topics that I've made videos on. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.